pre-FOMC today. Tomorrow is the FOMC minute, so the stock indexes are pretty choppy. But what the most interesting market of the day is the crude oil futures market. Taking a look at this massive sell-off that happened at 9:38 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and we look at this purple buildup right here in the order book to help us determine potentially a reversal. So I like to use these market depth count and market depth indicators to help determine reversals in the crude oil market and other futures markets. And today, crude oil is the most interesting market, so we're going to cover that market today. So I never, ever trust the news that I get in the crude oil market. And so let's take a look here. At 9:38, news was released that Saudi oil production would come back online quicker than expected. So the supply concerns decreased. Crude oil sold off in about three different waves here. And it was done at 10:50, so about an hour and 20 minutes in. The selling was done. And the news event, I would not be surprised to see this whole thing reverse to higher highs. Maybe not today, but I don't always trust what I hear in the crude oil markets. But one of the things that you could have done to, and maybe potentially anticipate this, was to look at the market depth count total indicator. And I'm going to explain how that works in a minute. But you see the buildup of purple right here. And when the market is up and you see a purple, that could be a sell signal. Purple is bearish when the market is up, and blue is bullish when the market is down. So you see some blues here. You see a mix of purple and blue. They're not the same. They're not the same magnitude as these right here. They're a little bit lower, so there's not as significant. But you know, I look at these intraday, not overnight. Overnight, it's not as telling. The order book is not as telling overnight. It is more telling intraday. It's thinner at night, so it's more inefficient. So you can see big spikes at night that don't mean anything. But during the day, it's more significant. So we haven't really seen a strong blue buildup yet. And when you see that strong blue buildup, that could be a good buy signal to then reverse and go long on crude oil if we get that. And so, but the purple was a potentially a good indicator. It occurred right here. So a few minutes before it happened, stock market opened at 9:31, about here, and 7 minutes in, crude oil just tanks. And so I don't trust that. There's a lot of desire to, I mean, the stocks open, and you know they want the market to go up. And so reports are released to do anything to make the stock market more bullish in order to make the market go up. And so 7 minutes into the stock market session, that would have been bullish stock market news to know that crude oil was going down. And so I don't trust it, but you go with it in the short term if you can, using indicators like that. And so once again, market depth count, you're looking for an active market. And if the market is down and you see blue, that could be a buy signal. If the market is up and it's purple, it could be a good short signal. And these could also be used as oversold conditions. So if the market is, it represents selling. So if the market has already been beaten down and you see this kind of selling where the purple is real, real violent, kind of a curve here, then it could be oversold if the market is down. So you see that right there. So short signal if it's up, oversold if it's down. Blues could be a buy signal if the market is down, and it could be overbought if the market is up. So we're waiting to see another higher magnitude signal over here on the blues to determine if the crude oil market will then reverse and go higher. Let's get rid of all this so you can see it a little bit better. I'm going to remove the screen draw so the prices come back. It kind of freezes up when I put the screen draw on. So here's where we are right now. Not a lot of information yet to determine whether we should buy this or sell this. The trend is still down because we don't have a good blue signal. So you could continue to short this on rallies until you get a good blue signal to say, hey, let's go in and start buying the dips or buying it as it goes up now. So that is the update on crude oil, how to find reversals using market depth indicator. And now I want to explain to you how these market depth indicators work. The market depth is basically, you have 10 levels in the order book, bids and offers. And so I want to highlight this here. So when you see, for example, right here, the bottom indicator tells you at this point there are 204, the ask size is 204, the bid size is 630, and so the bid ratio is just the bid size divided by the ask size, so 3.07, and so that's a huge, huge number, and then the ask ratio is the inverse of that, and so we look for big numbers like that to potentially give us some trading information. When the order book is out of line, theoretically the order book should remain fairly balanced, and so when it gets out of line like this, there's potential opportunities to combine other techniques that you have with the order book. If you like price and volume trading, order book is related to the volume of what's going on inside the order book, and it can help you see imbalances and potential trade opportunities by looking for these spikes. The count, this is on a bar by bar basis. The bottom indicator is just the market depth total on each bar. And the market depth count, it counts how many bars the bids lead the offers. And so in this case, the bids lead the offers for 9 bars in a row. Over here, the offers led the bids 10 bars in a row. The bids led the offers for 8 bars in a row. And you can see not much is going on. They're just flip-flopping in here right now. They're hovering around 60, kind of a steady state price, and it's the order book is pretty balanced right now. So if you see, you can click on that and see 267 was the ask size, bid size was 256 right here. So they're pretty well balanced at this point, and we're looking for our next inefficiency, the next indicator to tell us where this market might be going. And so that is the market depth count total, the market depth indicators that we have that we like to use for determining reversals. And today it potentially forecasted a short sell reversal in crude oil futures.